Somebody once said that winning isn't everything, and that's true, but it sure does feel good. We started this campaign last February. I remember it well. It was, for us, a brisk, cool February morning, and now, 10 months, 64 parishes, 23 opponents, one sitting governor, thousands of miles traveled, I don't know, 20 debates. Here we are together, and we won. Thank you, Louisiana. And thanks to all of you, my supporters. I'd rather drink Weed Killer than be anywhere else than right here tonight. I received a call a few minutes ago from Commissioner Campbell, and I want to congratulate Commissioner Foster Campbell and Governor John Bel Edwards on the campaign they ran. They were worthy. They ran a spirited race. They were worthy opponents. You know, competition makes us, all of us, better. And I am looking forward to working with Foster and John Bel as we try to return Louisiana and America to prosperity. This campaign never was about me, and it never was about Commissioner Campbell, and it really never was about the other 22 fine people who ran for the U.S. Senate. This campaign was about change versus status quo. I'm going to say tonight what I said the first night, or the first day that we announced. I believe that America's best days lie ahead. I wouldn't run for this job, wouldn't have run had I not believed that, and I still believe it. I believe that our future can be better than our present or our past, but not if we keep going in the direction that the Washington insiders have taken us for the past 8 years, and that's about to change, folks, and I'm so happy and honored to be able to be a part of it. I want to say a word to the people who didn't vote for me. You know, I want to be a senator for all Louisianians. What unites us in Louisiana and America is deeper than what divides us. Let me say that again. I want, to those of you who didn't vote for me, I want to be your senator too. I don't care if you're rich or poor, man or woman, black, white, or brown, from North Louisiana or South Louisiana. I don't care what your zip code is. I don't care whether you're good looking or just average like me. To a bear, we all taste like chicken. And I'm kind of like that bear. I want to be a senator for everybody. You know, people know whether they're welcome at a party or not. And I want everybody in Louisiana, those who supported me and those who didn't, to know they're welcome at mine and always will be. Because in our state, everybody counts, everybody deserves a chance, and we're all better off when we stick together. Now, I've got some people I've got to thank. Boy, Becky's put up with a lot. It's a good thing she doesn't watch much TV. She has just been the best. Politics is not her profession, it's mine. And she tolerates it, and she allows me to do it, and I'm grateful, honey. Now, my son Preston couldn't be here tonight. His full name is James Preston Calhoun Kennedy. We had to make everybody in the family happy. We call him Preston, named him after my dad. Becky and I love him more than life itself. He couldn't come tonight because he's in exams. He's at Millsaps. And Dad's really proud of him. He's making his grades, and he's got no visible tattoos. So if he's listening, let's both keep making your grades and no visible tattoos. Who else is here tonight? Is my brother Richard out there, Dr. Richard Kennedy? Well, he came, and he's here somewhere. Richard and my nephew, Reynolds, there they are. Dr. Richard Kennedy, he came in from, come on up here, Richard, for God's sake. You came all the way from Olympia, Washington. My older brother, Dr. Tom Kennedy, is from Charlotte. He couldn't come. He's on call. George is here. Is George here? My brother George. I couldn't talk to him for 6 or 8 months because he was working for Super PACs. Bart and Kitty and little Bart Stolb. I don't know if they're here because my niece, Taylor, is a little under the weather. Taylor, if you're listening, Taylor was the only member of my family that had the guts to go to the Duke debate. She was the only one in my family. So thank you, Taylor. I hope you're feeling better. I want to thank Kim Allen. Kim's the best campaign manager you can find, y'all. She made these trains run on time and did everything else on top of it. I want to thank the best fundraiser in America, Courtney Guastella. Where's Courtney?